Hello dear students, welcome to the online theory class. Students, in the last class, means yesterday class, we already discussed one very important 3 marks concept, that is SN1 reaction with mechanism as well as SN2 mechanism. I already told you every year there is a question on SN1 or SN2 mechanism. It is compulsory, right? Yes. Students, in this video, I'm going to discuss some definition points. See, here one by one. First one, definition for plane polarized light. What is plane polarized light? Students, when one of the ordinary light, if it is passed through one particular prism, if an ordinary light is passed through a Nicole prism, usually that particular prism is also called as Nicole prism, it vibrates single beam of light. When one particular ordinary light, if it is passed through a prism, then it vibrates in a single beam. That beam of light is called plane polarized light, or also simply it is written as PPL, PPL, plane polarized light. See here one diagram is given, right? Here the light, ordinary light, is transferred through one prism. Like if you take prism like this, usually no prism again and the way on pataka the mulaka on the light and pass madidaga. But the ordinary light and now on pataka the mulaka nama transfer madidaga the enacta the one the nikaravadanta on the position and a perkolta andre iliado single beam of light and the unskolta. Students, if you observe some textbook, they given another definition for a plane polarized light. Simply, you also note this point. It is a beam of light. It is a beam of light which has vibrations. Which has vibrations. Which has vibrations in only one plane. Only one plane. Andre, you want the light, Ilian Akta, one the particular plane ali, Muak Tairodu, Kandabartada. Right? They given light from ordinary lamp consists of waves. Means ordinary light, there is no direction. It moves in all direction. Right? Yes. When it passed through a polarized lens, or also called as prism, right, it is found to vibrate in one plane. It is said to be plane polarized light or polarized light. Clear? Remember the definition point. Plane polarized light. It is the beam of light which has vibrations in only one plane. Either vibration na onde onda dikkinalli irutada onde neera dikkinalli irutada adre ordinary light nodri ello light hachirtave ello kade enagirtada belak bidirtada andre avukur moment any direction dolad kandu bartirtada, right? Yes. Another definition point, optical isomerism. Very important, optical isomerism. I think in the previous year we already know optical isomerism. How you define that term? Remember once again, two or more than two compounds. Two or more than two compounds having same molecular formula but differ in the rotation. See here. Observe my point carefully. Two or more than two compounds having same molecular formula but differ in the rotation, either D or L with specific angle. This is very important. Usually students, optically active compounds can exist in two isomeric forms. Usually optically active substances are exist in presence of two isomeric forms which rotate the plane polarized light in opposite direction. I think you know well about dextro and levo rotatory substance, and dextro rotatory substance are indicated by D and levo rotatory substance are indicated by L, right? Yes, those are two isomeric forms. Remember students, here two or more than two compounds having same molecular formula but differ in the rotation, means differ in the rotation means it indicates either D or L configuration with the specific angle is called optical isomerism. See here one example, I take lactic acid, right? Lactic acid. What is the structure of lactic acid? I think in the biomolecules chapter also I discussed this term, right? HOH, and in the bottom side there is a COOH group. Yes, if I placed mirror here, then its mirror image is, here I write CS3 and here C, and this OH group is appeared here and H here, right? And your COOH. Students, here the OH group, it is present on right side. S means I write D plus. And here OH, it is in left side, right? Therefore, I write L, indicated by negative sign. These are optical isomers. Optical isomers. They are optical isomers. Two or more than two compounds having same molecular formula. If you observe the molecular formula of these two, they have same molecular formula but different in the rotation, because here OH group is present on right side, here it is in left side, right? And these are arranged in a specific rotation and specific angle, that is called optical isomerism. Yes, another word I taken here, that is optical activity. What is optical activity? Remember students, it is one of the property by which solution of some compounds rotate a plane of polarized light either to the right or left. The compounds which exhibit optical activity are called as optically active compounds. Remember, this one is very important. Substance which operates the optical activity, those are optically active compounds. And remember another thing, optical activity, it is one of the property in which solution of some particular compounds, they rotate the plane polarized light either towards clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. ಇಗೊಂದು ಯಾವುದೋ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್, ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತದ ಅದ್ಯಾವುದು? ಡೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೋ ರೊಟೇಟರಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಹಂಗ ಕರೆದಿದ್ರು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನ ಮತ್ತೀಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ಡ್ ಟು ದ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್, ದೆನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸರ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್, ರೈಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಟರ್ನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸಿಂಬಾಲ್ ಟುವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಕ್ವೈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್. ಹೌದಾ? ಈಗ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ಈಗ ಇಲ್ಲೊಂದು ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಬೀಕರ್ ಅದ. ಹೌದಾ? ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಗ್ಲೂಕೋಸ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಹೌದಾ? ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿರ್ತದ? ಇವಾಗ ಪೋಲರೈಸರ್ ಅಥವಾ ಡಿಟೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಏನೇನು ಕರಿತೇವಲ್ಲ, ಅದೇನಾಗ್ತದ? ಈ ಒಂದು ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ನ ಕ್ಲಾಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ದೊಳಗ ಮೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತದ, ಅಂದ್ರೆ ತೋರಿಸ್ತದ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೂವ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ಗಿವನ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೋ, ರೈಟ್? ಎಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆರಿಮೆಂಟಲಿ ಇದನ್ನ ಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ನಾವು. ಓಕೆ, ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ರೊಟೇಟ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಐದರ್ ಟು ದ ರೈಟ್ ಆರ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್, the phenomenon involved in, that is optical activity. Right, here some properties of optical isomerisms are given. See one by one. Optical isomerism is caused by lack of symmetry in a molecule's structures, so that the molecule and its mirror image are actually different. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಒಂದು ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಇವು ಕಂಡು ಬರ್ತಾವ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಈಸ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಆರ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸಿಬಲ್? ನೋ. ನಾವೀಗ ಒಂದು ಕೈ ಒಳಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಡಗೈ ಒಳಗೆ ಬಲಗೈಯನ್ನ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದಾ? ಇಲ್ಲ. ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಎಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದೇ ಗಿವನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ಐಸೋಮರ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಒಂದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದು ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹಿಡಿಯೋಕೆ ಸಾಧ್ಯ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನು. ಹೌದಾ? ಎಸ್. ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಎಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಯು ನೋ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಡೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೋ ರೊಟೇಟರಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ and what are levorotatory substance? See here they given an optically active compound. Why they given optically active compound here? Because those type of compounds only shows the deflection. Based on the direction of deflection, they are referred as dextrorotatory or levorotatory, right? Yes. See here, an optically active compound that rotates plane polarized light in a clockwise direction. Yes. If an optically active compound, it rotates the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction, then it is dextrorotatory substance. What is optically active substance or compound here? When a plane polarized light is passed through a solution of one particular substance, if it vibrates either clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, then it is optically active substance. Then you can easily define what is an optically inactive compound or optically inactive substance. Remember students, if a plane polarized light is passed through a one particular solution or solution of the substance, it cannot vibrates in any direction, it cannot vibrates either in clockwise or anti-clockwise, then that substance is called as optically inactive substance. Right? Yes. Okay. Now, dextrorotatory substance. What are dextrorotatory substance? An optically active compound that rotates the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction. Yes. Here they written small d. Remember, don't confuse with d. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಾ ಈ ಡಿ ಅನ್ನ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬರೀತಾರ ಅಂತ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಯೋಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಒಳಗೆ ಹೇಳೇನೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳೇನೆ. ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬರೀತಿದ್ರು, ಹೌದಾ, ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಲಕ್ಷ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರಿ. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಟಮ್ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೈಡ್, ಎನೋಮರಿಕ್ ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಐಟಮ್ ಕಂಟೈನಿಂಗ್ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಆನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಸೈಡ್, ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಬೇರೆನ ಮತ್ತ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅವನ್ನ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಡ್ರಿ. ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಎಸ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿವೋರೋಟೇಟರಿ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್? An optically active compound that rotates the plane polarized light in anti-clockwise direction. I think it's clear to you what are dextrorotatory substance and what are levorotatory substance. Here it is also optically active compound. Why? Because it moves the polarized light in a anti-clockwise direction. There is a movement, right? Yes. It is indicated by negative sign or small l. Yes. Students, one more thing you remember, the angle of rotation of plane polarized light by an optically active substance, by angle of rotation of plane polarized light by optically active substance is proportional to the number of atoms in the path of light. Is helpful for your CET examination. Okay. See some examples. here one example they given lactic acid and they written plus or d lactic acid. Yes, because this compound operates the plane polarized light in a clockwise direction, right? Yes, and here anti-clockwise direction. So the name of this compound is given as L-lactic acid and this one is given as D-lactic acid. But you must and should know the structure of lactic acid first. Il nodri D-lactic acid, L-lactic acid. You could structure got the matra example baritir new. OHO, COHO, CS3HO, you barta vannuda gottirla andra inada D and L kate durana ulitu. Okay. But here in this chapter especially the definition point of these terms are very important. They may ask one mark question on this concept. Okay students, next another one very important. I write here very 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 important because so many times this question is asked in your annual examination, but very easy definition. Racemic mixture. How you define this term? They given equimolar means 50-50 mixture of two enantiomers is called racemic mixtures. Yes, but we don't know about enantiomers, right? So I changed the definition point. This is also one of the definition. But now I take another definition. Students, remember the equimolar mixture of dextro and levo form of compounds. Remember, equimolar means 50-50% of mixture of dextro and levo rotatory substance or compounds called racemic mixture. Note down the point. Equimolar mixture of dextro and levorotatory substances. Equimolar mixture of dextro and levorotatory substance are called it is a mixture, so substance is called racemic mixture. Very important for one mark question. Remember racemic mixture. Okay. Yes, what is that equimolar mixture? It contains 50% of D and 50% of L isomer. If you take an example, 50% of D lactic acid and 50% of L lactic acid, both are mixed, right? Then it is racemic mixture. How you define this term? An equimolar mixture of dextro and levo rotatory substance or compounds is called racemic mixture. Students, one more thing you remember, racemic mixture is always optically inactive. Here I take one point. Racemic mixture, it is optically inactive. It is optically inactive. I think already you know what are optically inactive substances. They do not show deflection either via clockwise or anti-clockwise direction, right? ಯಾವುದೇ ತರನಾದಂತ ಡಿಫ್ಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಅನ್ನ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಹೌದಾ ಅಂತ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ನಾವು ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಇನ್ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಬ್ಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತಿದ್ವಿ ಹಿಯರ್ ರೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಇನ್ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ರೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಇನ್ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಗಿವ್ ರೀಸನ್ ದೆನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಈಸ್ racemic mixture is optically inactive because it contain equimolar mixture of dextro and levo rotatory substance. Ili 50% D aiti 50% L aiti eradunu koodisbitre enagibirtada ओवरऑल जीरो देर इज नो डिफ्लेक्शन देयरफॉर रेसमिक मिक्सचर इज ऑप्टिकली इनएक्टिव. नेक्स्ट अनदर डेफिनेशन पॉइंट यूजुअली एनांसोमर्स द वर्ड इज टेकन हियर वी विल सी इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड व्हाट आर एनांसोमर्स. आई थिंक by observing the definition point of racemic mixture which I given equimolar mixture of dextrorotatory and levorotatory substance levorotatory and dextrorotatory substance mixtures are called as enantiomers we will see later. Yes, resolution. Next definition point resolution as one of the definition how you define this term. Yes, resolution. It is the process of separation of pure enantiomers from their racemic modification. Yes, usually it is one of the separation method. Separation of pure enantiomers from the racemic modification. Okay. See next one. First enantiomers. Enantiomers. Then we will see what is resolution. So yes. Students, enantiomer. Now, enantiomers are the chiral molecules that are mirror image of one another. Yes, see here, D lactic acid, L lactic acid, right? Yes. Enantiomers are the chiral molecules that are mirror image of one another. They have same physical properties. Usually, physical properties of enantiomers are similar. D lactic acid and L lactic acid D and L right. Yes, see here this term you also defined like this. What are enantiomers? Students, when you observe the structures I already given you one point. Those structures are optical isomers right. If you take this one D lactic acid and L lactic acid these are optical isomers right because they are mirror images. Yes, optical isomers which are the mirror images of each other. Simply you can define this enantiomers like enantiomers are the isomers are the isomers which type of isomers optical isomers enantiomers are the optical isomers which are the mirror images of each other called enantiomers. Definition point you remember what are enantiomers? These are the optical isomers which are the mirror images of each other. Is mirror images are superimposed on one another? No. These are non-superimposed mirror images. By using this term, by using a non-superimposed term, you can also define the enantiomers like enantiomers are non-superimposed mirror images. Enantiomers are non-superimposed mirror images. Structures are called enantiomers. Usually these are non-superimposed mirror images of structures of the compounds or molecules right. These are called enantiomers. If you observe different textbooks the enantiomer definition is different right. If you observe some textbook they given the D and L isomeric forms of compounds are called as enantiomers. Is it right? Right, because D and L both are mirror images and non-superimposable one another right. Therefore they given the D and L isomeric forms of compounds are called enantiomers. Yes, ig nimge gottagide enantiomers andre it is the mixture of D and L isomer right. ಈಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಎರಡೂ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಬರೆದಾಗ ಏನಾಗ್ತಾವ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಎನಾನ್ಸೋಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾವ. ದ ಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ ಐಸೋಮರಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ ದ ಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ ಐಸೋಮರಿಕ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಐಸೋ ಎನಾನ್ಸೋಮರ್ಸ್. Yes, I already told you one more point, definition point, resolution. See here, resolution. Now you observe the definition point. Resolution, it is one of the process which separation of D and L form of a racemic mixture. ಯೂಶಲಿ ನೀವು ಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಂತೀರಿ, ರೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೆದಿದ್ವಿ. ಆ ಒಂದು ರೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ ಇದ್ದದನ್ನ ಸಪರೇಟ್ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಒಂದು ವಿಧಾನ. ದ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಪರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಎ ರೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ರೆಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಎಸ್, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ರೆಸಮೈಜೇಷನ್. ರೆಸಮೈಜೇಷನ್, ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ರೆಸಮೈಜೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಕನ್ವರ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನಾನ್ಸೋಮರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ರೆಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್. You remember the definition point, these are important for one mark question. Racemization, what is racemization? The conversion of enantiomers into racemic mixture. Remember this much only. Racemization, it is the process in which the conversion of enantiomer into racemic mixture. Yes. Okay, students, next another one, symmetric and asymmetric carbon atom. What is symmetric carbon atom? The carbon atom which is attached to four similar atoms are called as symmetric carbon. See here, one of the carbon atom, its valency is 4, then it is surrounded by a similar group, then it is, then this carbon atom is symmetric carbon atom, right? If you take example CH4, yes, one of the carbon atom, it is surrounded by four similar hydrogen atoms, therefore the carbon atom present in methane, it is one of the symmetric carbon atom. Then what is asymmetric carbon atom? In biomolecules chapter you know this definition. What is asymmetric carbon atom? The carbon atom which is surrounded by four different atoms called asymmetric carbon atom. Just you observe the structure of lactic acid in previous slide. When you observe the structure of lactic acid, it appears like this. See here, C, one of the OH group and one H group, one CH3 group and another one COOH group. Yes, if you observe this carbon atom, middle carbon atom, it is surrounded by four different groups, right? Then definitely it is asymmetric carbon atom. Asymmetric carbon atom. Very important, what is asymmetric carbon atom and what is symmetric carbon atom? Remember both the definition. Yes. Students, next another one definition point, chirality. Students, first you know the meaning of chiral molecule before going to the chirality, because chirality, it is one of the phenomena. Okay, before going to the chirality, you must know what is chiral molecule. Students, remember the molecule is chiral if its two mirror image forms are not superimposable. Yes, igeldu molecule structure ana observe martta idiri adrulaga ondu innondakke sariyagi enada mirror image ada hoda mirror image iddu kuda adena agadilla superimposable alla andre ondakkondu sariyagi coincide agodilla. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಇದನ್ನ ಕೋಯಿನ್ಸೈಡ್ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ಈಗ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ತಂದಿಟ್ಟಾಗ ಎಚ್ ಎಚ್ ಮೇಲೇನೆ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಸಿ ಎಲ್ ಇತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಸಿ ಎಲ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕೊಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಇದ್ರೆ ಸಿ ಎಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಮೇಲೆ ಕಂಡು ಬರ್ಬೇಕು ಒಂದ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ದೊಳಗ. ಹಂಗ ಕಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ರಿ ಏನಂತಿದ್ರಿ, ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸಿಬಲ್. ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಸೇಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಎ ಕೈರಲ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ ದಟ್ ಕಂಟೈನ್ ಟು ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪೋಸಿಬಲ್. Remember, usually this chiral, it is a word derived from Greek. Usually its meaning is hand, right? Usually chirality, Right, it is one of the phenomenon. Usually it operates or observed in a compounds in which carbon that is attached to four different groups. See here the definition point of chirality now. This is important. What is chirality? What is chirality? I think one time in your annual examination, the definition point of chirality is asked. So remember, what is chirality? It is the property present in an object or molecule that cannot be superimposed on its mirror image. Very important. Remember this one. Chirality, it is the property. It is one of the phenomena present in an object. Here object, it may be our hand or it may be a particular molecule, compound, etc. Right? Chirality, it is the property or phenomenon present in an object that cannot be superimposed on its mirror image. Yes. Students, remember another definition point for this chirality. The object contain a symmetric carbon atom. Remember, the object which contain a symmetric carbon atom. Usually a symmetric carbon atom means it referred as a chiral molecule, right? Yes. The object contain a symmetric carbon atom and it is non-superimposed on its mirror image. The object contain a symmetric carbon atom and it is non-superimposed on its mirror image. That is called as chiral molecule, right? But the phenomenon is called, or process is called, chirality. See here, one structure is given, right? Your right hand is chiral because its mirror image, your left hand, it is not superimposable on each other. Igil nodri, ig mirror image illada, illi nim hand ada. Hauda, ig idanna illi nodri, illi enada ee direction da hodra aste idagtada. ಹೌದಾ ಬಟ್ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಅನ್ನ ಇದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಟ್ಟರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಬೆರಳು ಒಂದೇ ಸಮ ಬೆರಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರೋದಿಲ್ಲ ಹೌದಾ ಈಗ ನಾನು ಇದನ್ನ ಉಲ್ಟಾ ಇಟ್ರೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಕೆರೆಬೆರಳ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೆಬ್ಬೆರಳು ಬರುವಂತದ್ದು ಹಾಗೆ ಹೌದಾ ಎಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಕೈರಲ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಅಕೈರಲ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜಸ್ A chiral. Chiral means they are non-superimposed. But chiral means, sorry, a chiral means it has superimposable mirror images. When you observe the structure of mirror, one and another, they are superimposable. Andre, ee tara structures anna now ondar mel ond place madidre, onde direction place madidre. ಹಾಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ತದ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಕಂಡು ಬರ್ತದ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಕೈರಲ್ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮಿಜೋ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಮಿಜೋ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಮಿಜೋ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್ Usually, a chiral molecules, it has one or more elements of symmetry, such as plane of symmetry. Right? See here, meso compounds. What are meso compounds? A meso compound is a stereoisomer. I think you know about stereoisomerism. Yes. Change in the position either direction around the double bond or special arrangement is observed here, right? Yes, meso compound is a stereoisomer that is superimposable on its mirror image. Usually this meso compound concept, it is helpful for your CET, not for your theory. Yes, meso compound is a stereoisomer that is superimposable on its mirror image due to its internal plane of symmetry. See here, this structure clears about meso compounds. Here, this one is tartaric acid structure. It contains two COOH group, two H groups and two OH groups, right? If I draw a plane of symmetry, I shown here plane of symmetry. ಎಸ್, ಈಗ ನಾ ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅನ್ನ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಹೌದಾ, ಈ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಅನ್ನ ನಾನು ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ತಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೇನೆ, ಹೌದಾ. ಈ ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಏನೈತಲ್ಲ ಇದನ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಇದನ್ನ ನೀವು ಹೊಳಿಸ್ ಬಿಡ್ರಿ, ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ. ಈ ಸಿ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಅನ್ನ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ತಿರುವಿ ಬರ್ದಂಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಇಟ್ಟಂಗ, ಹೌದಾ. ಸಿ ಓ ಎಚ್, ಸಿ ಓ ಎಚ್, ಸಿ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂತು, ಎಚ್ ಎಚ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂತು, ಓ ಎಚ್ ಓ ಎಚ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಬಂತು. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಐಸೋಮರ್ಸ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್. ಮಿಸೋ ಕಂಪೌಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟೀರಿಯೋಐಸೋಮರ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆರ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಇಂಪಾಸಿಬಲ್ ಆನ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿರರ್ ಇಮೇಜ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಇಂಟರ್ನಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಮೆಟ್ರಿ. ಎಸ್, ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲಿ ಇನ್ಆಕ್ಟಿವ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್? ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ಎ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಪಿಪಿಎಲ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ 1 dm³ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಇಸ್ಲಿ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ಎ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ 1 dm³ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಗಿವನ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್. ಎಸ್, ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್, ರೆಫರ್ ದಟ್ ನೋಟ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ದೇ ಗಿವನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಫೈನ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್. ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ಡ್ ಆಂಗಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಕಲ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಫಾ ವೆನ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ಎ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ವಿತ್ ಎ ಪಾತ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ 1 dm ಅಂಡ್ ಸ್ಯಾಂಪಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 1 g/1 mm. ಸೋಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ಫುಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಇಟಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮುಲಾ ಆಲ್ಸೋ, ನಾಟ್ ಯು, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್. ಎ ರೊಟೇಷನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರೊಟೇಷನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ವೆನ್ ಪ್ಲೇನ್ ಪೋಲರೈಸ್ಡ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಡ್ ಥ್ರೂ ದ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ 1 dm³ ಲೆಂತ್ ರೈಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಗಿವನ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೈಟ್ ಅಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸ್ಟಂಟ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್. ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್, ನಾಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಟ್ ಆನ್ ಬೋತ್ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ಸ್. ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದೆಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ರೆಸಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ರೆಸಮಿಕ್ ಮಿಕ್ಸರ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಎನಾನ್ಶೋಮರ್ಸ್, ಎನಾನ್ಶೋಮರ್ಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಕೈರಾಲಿಟಿ. ಎಸ್, ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೈನ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಇಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ನೀಟ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್. ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ನೋ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡೆಫಿನೇಷನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ವ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸಿಇಟಿ ರೈಟ್. ಎಸ್, ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಸಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಾಲೋ ಆಲ್ಕೇನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್ ರೈಟ್. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.